Hello, everybody. Welcome to a new episode of
Jesse's Tips and Tricks.
Today, we're looking at a simple trick that will make your life a bit easier. I will show you how to ripple lead gaps in your video footage after you're done spotting in Adobe Premiere. I know these guys already know all about it, but if you don't, pay attention. This will come in handy. So, here's a timeline with your raw footage on it. And now you start spotting. Cut the parts you want to use in your video edit and place them on another video track. You can do so by dragging them or by selecting them and holding Alt and pressing the up arrow. So, here's the parts you want to use and here's the footage you don't need. If you delete the footage you don't need, there's going to be a lot of gaps in your timeline. So instead of just deleting, select the parts you want to get rid of, right click it and select Ripple Delete. Now there are no gaps and all the footage you want to keep working with is conveniently bundled together. Sometimes, for whatever reason,
I'm not judging anyone,
you might have a selection of footage you want to use with a lot of gaps in it, but without footage to ripple delete the gaps with. Now you could delete the gaps one by one,
but there's a faster way.
Go to the project window, right click, select new item and create a color mat. Or an adjustment layer or a transparent video or a picture of... whatever. Anything you can put on a video track and stretch it so it covers all the gaps will do. Let's just say we'll go for the color mat. Now put that on a video track above the selected material. Move the selected footage over the color mat, move it back, and now select all the pieces of the color mat. You can now right click it and select Ripple Delete. And there you are. You now have a timeline with all your spotted material tidily together. Easy as 1, 2, 3.